This episode of DNews is brought to you by the all-new G-Flex 2 from LG. Life's good.
Hey guys. Guys, how do my teeth look? Pretty good? Okay, great. Fluoride in the water might be helping that, but it might also be doing other things. Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I am Trace. Fluorine is the 13th most abundant element on the planet. It's in seawater, foods like fish, tea, and gelatin contain it, and it is a naturally occurring substance in minerals. That is to say, it's in all of the rocks, because it's everywhere. Fluorine is washed into the water supply during erosion, and then we drink it. Fluoride is just fluorine with an extra electron, and when we see it in toothpaste, food, or drinking water, it's actually sodium fluoride, or in our bodies, it's calcium fluoride. In the 1940s, scientists found that people living near natural water sources, with one part per million of fluoride, had fewer cavities. So they decided to add fluoride up to that concentration to reduce cavities for people who lived elsewhere. Unsurprisingly, controversy ensued. Today, two-thirds of Americans have fluoridated public water, but studies have thrown into question the benefit of waterborne fluoride compared to topical fluoride, or toothpaste with fluoride in it. A study of 23,000 skeletons from medieval archaeological sites found that people who lived near the coast and consumed fluoride-rich fish had fewer cavities. Another CDC study compared kids in the late 60s to kids in the early 90s and found a 68% drop in cavities over that time, perhaps due to fluoridated water, but it could have also been fluoride toothpaste. In the right concentrations, 0.8 to 1.2 parts per million, fluoride reduces tooth enamel solubility during its formation, helping it solidify and form teeth that are more resistant to bacterial attack. After the enamel is formed, though, fluoride helps prevent bacteria from producing acid that causes tooth decay. Of course, higher concentrations of fluoride can cause pitting in teeth, decay, and major health problems. Anything over 1.5 parts per million can cause tooth decay, and 3 to 6 parts per million can cause problems with the human skeleton. Although there are some Chinese studies correlating high fluoride with IQ problems, no US city is even close to a 4 parts per million EPA limit. Whether it's cool to add fluoride to the water is still a political and social point of contention. From a healthcare perspective, if we want our teeth to last, we gotta keep the enamel free of harmful bacterial deposits, which fluoride does. Enamel, the outermost layer of the tooth, is the toughest stuff in the body, but it can't repair itself. It needs help. Whether it belongs in the drinking water is a complicated question, because for those of us who didn't grow up with municipal drinking water, like me, we had it in our well water, because the earth put it there. Municipal sources get it as an odorless and tasteless byproduct of phosphate fertilizer making, and that has no perceptible changes to the water, according to the World Health Organization. The WHO also recommends community water fluoridation as the most effective public health measure for the prevention of dental decay. Countries and states are going to continue being on board with fluoridation until someone finds damning evidence that they shouldn't be, which in 70 years, no one has yet found. So for the moment, water fluoridation is still a thing, but what do you think about it? Do you even care? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and keep your teeth brushed.